بسم الله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وبعد. Amongst the many signs of Qiyamah that stare us in our face is the fact that undeserving people have been given public office. And not only do they hold the office, but in many instances, they hoard the office. And when you look at it, be it in political spheres or religious matters, organizations, institutes, they would not relinquish power at any level. Now, there is a verse of the Quran, and this is a verse of the fourth juz, the fourth chapter, the fifth verse, Surah An-Nisa, in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَا تُؤْتُوا السُّفَهَاءَ أَمْوَالَكُمُ الَّتِي جَعَلَ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ قِيَامًا, addressing the guardians of the orphan, that when the orphan reaches of age, but he or she is still not mentally competent, they are feeble-minded, they are mentally incompetent, then do not give them their money. Although Allah said, أَمْوَالَكُمْ, your money, وَإِنَّمَا أَضَافَهَا إِلَى ضَمِيرِ الْمُخَاطَبِ, the scholars say the reason why Allah said your money, meaning protect their wealth as you protect your own wealth. But pause for a moment, this is their own wealth, it belongs to them, their late father left it behind. But the Quran said, don't hand it over to them simply because they are not skilled, they are not competent, they are not mentally equipped, they are not matured enough. So the scholars say from this verse we learn, فِيهِ عَدَمُ تَفْوِيضِ شَيْءٍ إِلَى غَيْرِ أَهْلِ. If the Quran alerts us not to give the orphan his own wealth, then we should be all the more careful when we hand out post and position to people who unfortunately are seeking the post. وَيُقَاسُ عَلَيْهَا الْمَنَاصِبِ, and on that you can look at public posts, religious matters, people that are spearheading our organizations. So this is a serious alert, and this is one of the signs of Qiyamah. In essence, it's two qualities. Those that are in public office should probably introspect, and those around who would like to nominate, two things will dictate if a person is deserving. Number one, his selfless nature, and number two, his ikhlas and sincerity. May Allah bless the ummah with good leaders. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen.